All right, guys, this is the front squat. So later in the week, you should be working on a squat variant. So in the We Are the Mighty plan, that means you're either doing the front squat or the Zercher squat. So I'm gonna go over the front squat in this video. All remains the same for the most part as far as the breathing mechanics, what bar path should look like, depth, even stance for the most part from the back squat. So you wanna make sure that your stance where your heels are about shoulder width apart, toes are pointed out a little bit, knees are tracking over those toes, so you're actually actively twisting your knees so that your glute med, so part of your ass that you're probably not used to engaging, actually engages and keeps your knees out and tracked up. Good core stability. Now, the part that changes is we're going from putting the bar on our back to putting the bar on our front. And what this is gonna do is actually engage your core a little bit more because the bar is gonna wanna be pulling you forward rather than just kind of pushing you down as it does in the back squat. And then the other thing is it's gonna engage your kind of shoulders a little bit more because we're holding it up here. Now there's two grips and a modified version, which I'll have to run off camera and grab something, but two main grips, which is the Olympic grip, like the clean grip, which I'll show you first, and then the bodybuilder grip, or sometimes it's called the California front squat grip, that you can do based on your shoulder mobility, whatever works the best for you. So the first one is the clean grip, so the Olympic weightlifting grip. And all you're gonna do is take the same grip that you would if you were doing power cleans or cleans from the ground or rack cleans or anything like that, which is somewhere around your deadlift grip, just wider than shoulder width apart. And you're gonna come underneath the bar and place it on your collarbone and your front delts. So where the back squat is on your rear delts, you can think about this. You're making a shelf with your front delts and your collarbone for the bar to rest on. So what that looks like is this. And here I am. Based on your shoulder mobility, maybe you'll only have two fingers under, maybe three, maybe four. Do whatever's comfortable. But as you're doing this squat and you're coming, as you're down and you're coming up in this squat, you're gonna think about bringing your elbows up and presenting your chest so that you can actually guide the bar up in a more straight bar path. Whereas we're all in our ass and our tailbone in the low bar back squat, in the front squat, you can actually think about leading with your chest, leading with your nipples on this movement and with your elbows to ensure that your torso is staying erect and that you're upright enough to keep a good back position and get depth all at the same time. Now, the second grip would be the bodybuilder grip or the California front squat is what it's sometimes called. And all that is you're gonna come in the same way and you're gonna cross your hands over each other and just hold the bar or get them on your delts in the front. This is a little bit more, takes a little bit more balance. People tend to do less weight with this, but we're not going super heavy with the front squat, so it shouldn't really matter too much. You can do whatever feels good for your front, the front of your shoulders, for your front delts. Now, there's one modification I wanna show. I'm gonna run off camera real quick. So, if you just don't have the mobility and you don't wanna do the Zercher squat, which is the other option, you can take some wrist straps that you maybe use for deadlifts or God forbid, bicep curl. Shouldn't be doing that, but you can take them and put them on the bar here where your grip would normally be. Get this guy in here. These are homemade wrist straps that I made out of a old seatbelt. So they're hanging here, and all I'm gonna do is the same grip, but I'm gonna grab higher so that I have more, so I need less mobility in my shoulders. You can do that for a while, but the goal should be to try to get closer and closer to actually being able to hold the bar. I'll do one rep of the front squat and then we'll call it a day, but it should be pretty self-explanatory since you already know how to back squat and there's not that much difference. What I will have you note is my torso, how much more upright I am. And that's the reason this movement is more quad dominant, because actually in the back squat, I'm forward. I have a forward lean to my upper body, which is causing a closer angle in my hips. But as we do the front squat, I'm trying to stay more upright. And actually the squat is moving into my knees more and staying out of my hips as much. So it's actually, because the quad is a knee extensor muscle, it's using quads much more. So it's gonna look like this, where I'm a lot more upright versus the back squat where I'm further back. So let's do a rep and then we'll be ready to roll. That's it. That's the front squat.